Hello and welcome to the presentation on design of machine elements 2. We are going through the unit number 3, rolling mounted bearing, and now we will see some numericals based on rolling mounted bearing. So this is what the content that we have seen up till now on this particular unit, and now we will try to solve one numerical. So the statement of this numerical is this: an electric motor which is running at 1500 rpm is directly coupled to a shaft of 25mm diameter which is supported by two cylindrical roller bearings. So there is an electric motor whose rpm is 1500 and it is directly coupled to a shaft of 25mm diameter, and this shaft is supported on two cylindrical roller bearings. Okay, so you can see the arrangement is like this. So this is the bearing 1 and this is bearing 2, okay, and this is electric motor. So this electric motor having 1500 rpm is connected to this particular shaft. This shaft is there and it is supported into these two bearings. So now the next line is: the shaft transmits power to another line shaft through a flat pulley of 200 mm which is placed midway between the two bearings. The tension on the tight and slack side of the belt is 4980 and 1660 Newton respectively. So it is said that this particular shaft, okay, which is taking power from this particular motor, is delivering it to some another machine through a particular pulley. So this is that pulley which is mounted on the same shaft, okay, and it is transmitting this power by using a belt drive to some other machinery. Okay, so there is a belt here and it is transmitting power to some other machinery, and the tension on the tight side is 4980 Newton and tension on the slack side is 1660 Newton. This is given to us. Okay, so next line is: the belt is horizontal and the load factor is 1.4. So this is what we have shown, the horizontal belt here just now, having the tension T1 and T2. So belt is horizontal and the load factor is 1.4. so K value is given to us here, that is 1.4, and the expected life of the bearing is 40,000 hours. So in hours this life is specified, okay, and we are asked to find the dynamic load carrying capacity. That means C you have to find out, okay, of this bearing, so that the bearing can be selected from the manufacturer's catalog. So I hope you understood the given data, that there is a motor connected to this particular shaft which is supported to these bearings, and this shaft is again transmitting power to some another machine through a belt drive having this tension T1 and T2 through this particular pulley. Okay, this pulley is having diameter 200 mm, load factor is 1.4, and the expected life of this bearing is this bearing 40,000 hours, and you have to determine the value of C for this particular bearing. So let us start for the solution of this. So we know that the load life relationship is given by Lm is equal to C by P bracket S2A, where this Lm is actually the rating life in million revolutions, and C is the dynamic load carrying capacity which you have to find out, P is the equivalent radial load. So this is unknown that you have to find out, okay, and A is actually a constant which is 10 by 3 for the roller bearing. So first of all, the given rating life we will find out in million revolutions, so that can be obtained by using life in hours multiplied by number of revolutions per minute which is with which it is rotating, multiplied by 60 divided by 10 to 6. This, we are converting this in terms of million revolutions. Okay, so now let us do that. So C we have already defined. Now P is actually equivalent radial load on the bearing. So P is given by K into in bracket X into V into FR plus Y into FA, where this K is load factor, X and Y are the radial and thrust factors, and FR and FA are the radial and axial force acting on the bearing, and V is the rotation factor. So it means if my aim is to find out this value of C, so I should make means first of all I should know the value of this L10 and this PE. So L10 is given by LH into N into 60 by N 10 to 6. So LH is already known to me, so I can find out this L10 which I can utilize in this equation, and P that can be calculated by using this particular equation which involves FR, FA, X, V, okay, and Y. So first I have to find out the FR and FA acting on this particular bearing, means radial force and axial force on that bearing if it is there, and then I will find out the X and Y factors, and then V also I have to consider. So definitely in this case the shaft is rotating, so definitely inner rest will be rotated, so therefore V will be equal to 1. So once I get the P, then I will be using this P and L10 to get this value of C on this equation. So now let us find out the L10 first. So I am putting the LH here, that is 40,000 multiplied by 1500 multiplied by 60 divided by 106. So I will be getting this L10 as 3600 million revolutions. Now I will try to find out the radial load acting on this particular bearing, equivalent radial load. So for that I need the some factors. Load factor is already given, 1.4. So x factor is 1 and y factor is 0, because there is no axial force as such. So definitely y factor will itself will be 0, because there is no axial force, so only radial force is there. And as I have considered that the shaft is rotating, so nrs will rotate, therefore v is equal to 1. Now let us find out the radial force acting on that bearing. So fr will be nothing but the total load at the center. So total load at the center, what will be there? This is nothing but T1 plus T2. So whatever the tension on right side plus tension on slack side, the total force will be acting over the center. So if I take the mean of that, so T1 plus T2 by 2 will be nothing but equal to 3320 Newton. Okay. So actually the total load acting over here is T1 plus T2. Okay. And this total load will be carried half by this bearing and half by this bearing. So since it is equally divided, as this particular pulley is exactly at the center, and therefore we are divided by 2. Okay, so T1 plus T2 is the total force acting on this shaft, and this will be divided by 2. Half will be shared by this bearing, half will be shared by this bearing, therefore it is divided by 2 and its magnitude is 3320 Newton. So if I put the value of K, X equal to 1, V equal to 1 and FR equal to 3320, so I will be simply getting the total product as 4648 Newton. Okay, now this P and this value of L10, if I am putting into the load life relationship, so here I have to use A as 10 by 3 for the roller bearing. So this is L10 I am putting here, and this is a P equivalent I am putting here. So I will be getting this value of C as 54219.67 Newton, and this is what is nothing but the dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. And this is what is the answer for this particular numerical. So thank you very much.